In our daily life, we often hear the phrases, "He is a real command and control type," or "She is a consensus leader." These metaphors tell us how a leader deals with people. What is his behavior and attitude? Over time, leaders' behavior begins to reveal a consistent, regular, and predictable pattern of dealing with people and situations. This pattern of behavior and attitudes become the style of the leader. Leadership styles are based on two key dimensions of leadership behavior: initiating structure and consideration. Leadership style has a deep impact on the group productivity and performance. Moreover, it conveys the information on employees' job satisfaction. Researchers have classified leadership styles into the following categories: participative leadership style, autocratic leadership style, leadership grid, and entrepreneurial leadership style. Participative leadership exhibits team approach, as leader accepts suggestions from group members related to managing day-to-day operations. He also involves them in the decision-making process. Participative leadership has become a norm of many modern-day organizations. Participative approach of leadership can be further divided into three subtypes: consultative leadership. Consultative leaders consult with group members before making any decision, but the leader retains the final authority to make decisions. Consensus leadership. Consensus leaders look for general agreement in discussions and decision-making process. They tend to remove conflicts and seek team's support. All the stakeholders give input. However, final decision is agreed upon by all the members of the staff. Democratic leadership. Democratic leaders vote the opinion of every participant. However, they retain the final authority with themselves to accept or reject a decision. Participative style is based upon openness and transparency. Team leaders warmly welcome the suggestions, ideas, and change from the group members. As we see with the contemporary decentralized organizational structure, team members share more independence and responsibility. Especially frontline workers, as they work in direct collaboration with customers, can provide useful information about market trends and customer expectations. Later, leaders may use this information to develop business plans as well as market strategy. Participative leaders believe in teamwork. They frequently exhibit the behavior of coaching and guiding followers, negotiating their demands and needs, and collaborating with others. Participative leadership style is well suited to lead skillful and educated people. Such people love to take responsibility, give feedback, and be the part of decision making process. Participative style comes with some inherent issues. For example, it may be time consuming, as leaders may spend considerable time in meetings and discussions. Moreover, consensus and democratic leaders are often accused of providing too little direction and control, thus leading to a macro-management problem. At the other extreme, they consult team members for trivial things, causing delays in operation. Finally, many team leaders feel that involving others in decision-making process does result in reducing the power of leaders. Opposite to the participative leadership is autocratic leadership style. Autocratic leaders retain power, control, and authority with them. They confidently take decisions, assuming others will comply to their decisions. They are also called task-oriented leaders, as they focus on goal accomplishment. Autocratic leaders are least concerned about their popularity among team members. They can be effective in many situations which demand discipline and order. For example, military organizations need autocratic leadership. Similarly, the organizations which have plans ready but lack in the execution may need autocratic leadership. At the extreme of autocratic style, leader may appear impulsive or stubborn, but genuine autocratic leaders balance their authority with appreciation of talent and teamwork. The leadership grid. Blake and Mouton of the University of Texas proposed a two-dimensional leadership theory known as the leadership grid. This theory has been built on the work of Ohio State University and Michigan University. Leadership grid is a framework for specifying the extent of a leader's concern for production and people. It incorporates both initiating structure and consideration behavior to achieve effective leadership style. The leadership grid may be put into following subclasses of leadership style: authority compliance, country club management, impoverished management, middle of the road management, team management style. Leadership grid style takes a two-dimensional approach to present the concern for production and concern for people. X-axis represents the concern for production, whereas Y-axis gives the concern for people. Each concern takes a value from 1 to 9, where value 1 means the minimum score for that specific concern, and value 9 means the maximum score for the corresponding concern. Leadership grid style presents the 5 major leadership styles: authority compliance, having the value 9 and 1 on the grid. The value 9 means that concern for production is maximum, and value 1 means the concern for people is the minimum. Likewise, country club management has the value 1 and 9, where 1 means the minimum concern for the production and maximum concern for the people. Impoverished management, which takes the value 1 for both concerns, this means both concerns have the minimum score on the grid. Middle of the road management, that takes value 5 for each concern type. And at the end, team management, which takes maximum value for each concern type. The maximum concern for the production as well as the maximum score for the people. In the two-dimensional plane, authority compliance management has the value 9 and 1. This means the maximum concern for the production and minimum concern for the people. Authority compliance management leadership gives more emphasis on task completion and meeting job requirements. And it gives little emphasis on meeting people's demand. Moreover, communication is underemphasized in authority compliance management. Leaders like to give orders and they love their orders to be complied. Leadership is more controlling, demanding, and overpowering. Now, how it would affect the organization? As the leaders are task-oriented, so the organization will reach the peak performance. However, this peak performance will be short-lived as people will tend to leave the organization. There would be dissatisfaction among the team members as they are not being heard by the authority. Their demands are not being met. Their relationship with the leader is the weakest of the type. So there is dissatisfaction among the group members. Moreover, there would be higher turnover ratio. Country club management leadership has the minimum concern for the production, while it has the maximum concern for the people. Leaders tend to give little emphasis to the job accomplishment. However, they are more concerned with the people. They tend to build interpersonal relationships at the cost of low production. Leadership is characterized as agreeable, willing to help, comforting, and uncontroversial. There would be no conflicts among team members. Employees would be more satisfied. However, organization will suffer at the cost of production and production quality. Impoverished management receives the minimum score for both concern types. Leaders have minimal concern for people and production. It can be described as ineffective leadership, lacking in any traits that can be attributed to effective leaders. Employees develop high degree of dissatisfaction, group harmony, high turnover, whereas it also put impact on the organization. as organization will suffer inefficient operations and production. Leadership can be described as indifferent, non-committal, resigned, and apathetic. Middle of the road management style is a compromise between concern for production and concern for people. Leaders take a middle approach to balance out the needs of the employees with the production. Leaders avoid conflicts and emphasize moderate levels of production and establish relations with team members. Leaders can be described as supportive, soft pedal disagreement, and they are interested in group progress rather than implementing their own convictions. Though leaders try to achieve both concerns, however, both concerns are not adequately met. Team management leadership style achieves the maximum score at both fronts, the concern for production and the concern for people. These leaders put strong emphasis on both task as well as interpersonal relationships. Leaders promote high degree of participation and teamwork. Leaders are inclined to be supportive, caring, and sensitive to the needs of the team members. They build a cohesive team. They instill enthusiasm to the team members. Leaders are characterized as clear, open-minded, and determined, and stimulates participation. Team management is considered the best approach, the best style that achieves the maximum performance for both behavior types. Entrepreneurial leadership. In general, an entrepreneur is a person who establishes and operates an innovative business. Entrepreneur leaders exhibit strong work-centered and interpersonal personality. They have skills like strong achievement drive and sensible risk-taking. They have strong achievement motives. Establishing a business takes commitment and involves risks. But entrepreneur is ready to work long hours and take calculated risks. They have high degree of enthusiasm and creativity. Entrepreneurs are highly enthusiastic about achieving their dreams. Their enthusiasm and self-motivation combined with creative minds result into novel solutions. Entrepreneurs are smart enough to seize opportunities as they arise. They quickly act upon the opportunities. They are in constant hurry combined with impatience. They are quick to act upon ideas and decisions. Most often, their enthusiasm to accomplish something big is regarded as impatience. Entrepreneurs have visionary perspective. They see opportunities where others see problems. They look deep into the future where others fail to see. Their vision makes them different from other leaders. They dislike hierarchy and bureaucracy. Entrepreneurs get frustrated with rules and regulations and conventional hierarchical system of getting things done. They believe in teamwork and collaboration. They prefer for dealing with external customers. They prefer to deal with entities outside their organization. They focus more on products, customers, and opportunities than employees. They have eye on the future. Entrepreneurs don't feel satisfied with just one product or accomplishment. They keep setting new goals for themselves. While working on the current business plan, they keep thinking about next business opportunity. Having discussed different leadership styles, it is natural to ask which leadership style is the best. The answer is quite difficult. Even after years of study and research, researchers haven't agreed upon a best and most effective leadership style. In fact, the effective leaders don't rely on a single style. They keep changing their style from situation to situation. At one occasion, they might exhibit autocratic style, while at some other place, they exhibit democratic style. Another consideration is the culture in which leadership takes place. It may include national as well as organizational culture. For example, German workers are performance oriented. They need little compassion at workplace. Hence, task-oriented leadership style is best suited in such a culture. The organizational culture also influences which leadership style will be tolerated and accepted. A friendly, collaborative culture calls for more of a consensus style of leadership. In contrast, in a perform or perish culture, it calls for autocratic leadership. In today's rapidly changing world, an effective leader is the one who is flexible and adaptable. A leader who focuses on both initiating structure and consideration. Only such a leader is effective who keeps equilibrium in production, quality, and satisfaction. Behavioral approaches to leadership attempt to specify which kinds of leader behaviors are necessary for effective leadership. The theory provides a clear benefit to military and many other organizations that need practical leadership because it supports the belief that anyone is capable of becoming a leader. Individuals can learn and adapt the behaviors of successful leaders. And it is quite easier to learn a behavior than changing one's trait. Likewise, it allows leaders to be flexible and adaptable based on the circumstances and situations. Leaders can learn and decide what actions they want to implement to become the kind of leader they want to be. At the same time, there are some disadvantages and limitations of the behavioral theory. While it allows flexibility, it doesn't directly suggest how to behave in certain circumstances and situations. There are a number of leadership styles that stem from the behavioral theory, but there is not a right one for every situation. Furthermore, behavioral theory doesn't take into account the interaction between people, nature of task, and the environment.